think when in an asphalt laboratory. Technicians handle items that are hot, heavy, and moving.
Proper PPE is paramount for everyone's safety. Therefore, a lab coat and eye protection must be worn at all times. Be alert. Other people may be working in the lab with you. Be aware of where they are and what they may be working on.
Keep your hands clear of moving parts. Some of the equipment use hydraulics to apply loads to specimens. This can be a pinch point if a hand or finger is caught. Do not just push buttons.
Much of the equipment in an asphalt laboratory requires calibration to maintain accreditation.
Just pushing buttons on a piece of equipment that you are unfamiliar with could lead to injury or damage to the equipment. Technicians come into contact with hot materials, tools, and equipment. Long pants are required. Jeans or khakis would be fine. Open-toed shoes are not allowed in the laboratory. Only closed-toed shoes. Steel-toed shoes are not required, but are encouraged. If you are working with a Marshall hammer, hearing protection is also required. For your safety, assume that all items in a mixture laboratory are hot. One common saying in mixture laboratories is that hot metal looks the same as cold metal. For other safety, cover and mark items that are hot.
The asphalt ignition furnace burns at more than 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit and therefore must be respected.
The PPE required when working with the ignition furnace is a face shield, high heat resistant gloves, and a lab coat or apron. Along with the PPE, specialized prongs are used to move baskets in and out of the ignition furnace. Covering and labeling the baskets are essential to the safety of everyone working in the area. When cleaning baskets, a mask is required to keep from inhaling the dust particles from the scrubbing process. The chemicals used in the asphalt extraction process pose a danger. Therefore, a mask and chemical-resistant or rubber gloves are required. A ventilation hood is required when using harmful chemicals to further extract the fumes. Trimming specimen with a wet saw can be just as dangerous as any other saw. Particular care needs to be taken to keep hands and fingers away from the blades. Eye protection and hearing protection are required when using the saws. Take the time to locate first aid kits and eyewash stations. Knowing the location of these items will save time if an incident were to occur.
In the event of an asphalt burn, cool affected area with cold water or ice until medical emergency personnel arrive.
Always make sure that there was someone in the laboratory when you are working. If an incident were to occur, there would be someone close by to assist. Safety is everyone's responsibility. PPE is provided for your safety. Use it. We want everyone to be able to work in a safe and productive laboratory.